Before we start with this tutorial, let's talk about what a navbar really is. A navbar is a very common component on every website. Since it's a crucial part of a website, a navbar needs to have certain features. Firstly, it should be easy to navigate to improve the user browsing experience. Secondly, it should be responsive and adapt well to different screen sizes. In this tutorial, we will provide a complete guide on creating a navigation bar using only HTML and CSS. You can use this for your simple website or even for commercial ones. So without further delay, let's get started. In our HTML file, we will use the nav tag to create a navigation bar, which represents a section of links for web crawlers to navigate through. Following this, we will implement a div with the classes container and main nav to wrap the logo and navigation links. Similarly, to create our navbar logo, we will utilize a simple anchor tag with a class logo. Since we won't be incorporating JavaScript for this navigation bar, we will utilize the input tag with the type checkbox and assign it an ID of toggleBTN. This checkbox will later be configured to toggle the visibility of the navigation bar. To make it user-friendly, we will use the label tag to label the checkbox and specify its corresponding ID, as well as assign it a class of toggler. After setting up the checkbox and label for the toggler, we will need an icon to represent the toggler. To accomplish this, we will search for the Unicode for the toggle icon on Google and then copy and paste the Unicode symbol within our label tag. Next, let's proceed with creating the navigation links. Our navigation link will be wrapped within an unordered list with class navbar. Similarly, each navigation item will be within a list item with the class navItem. Inside this, we will create an anchor tag with the class navLink to represent the navigation link. Now, for the other navigation link, we can simply copy and paste this list item element into the unordered list. So now that we have finished structuring the HTML for the navbar, let's move on to CSS. In the CSS file, you'll see that I've imported the Poppins font to be used specifically for this navbar project. Furthermore, I've implemented default styles for both global elements and pseudo elements. To start, we'll apply styles to our container class. We will set its maximum width to 1070 pixels. Similarly, we will set the top and bottom margins to 0, and the left and right margins to auto to center the container horizontally. Likewise, the top and bottom padding will be 0, while the left and right padding will be 15px. For the nav tag, I will set the background color to be a vibrant purple. The top and bottom padding will be 30 pixels, while the left and right padding will be 0. I will set the position of the navbar to fixed so that it remains at the top even when the user scrolls. Additionally, I will set the top, right, and left properties to 0 to ensure that the navigation bar spans the full width of the viewport and sticks to the top of the page. Similarly, we will use the class main nav to make the wrapper element display as flex. This will align the logo and navigation links horizontally. To center the elements vertically, we will set its align items property to center. Likewise, we will specify justified content as space between to create space between the flex items. Next, to make sure the navbar toggle only works on mobile devices, we will hide the input checkbox and its corresponding label. We'll target the element with the ID toggleBTN and the class toggler, and set its display property to none. Now we will customize the logo. We'll change the font size to 1.2rem, the color to white, and the font weight to 800 to make it bolder. In the next step, we'll focus on the UL element containing our navigation links. We want the links to be positioned on the right side of the screen. To do this, we'll set the margin left property to auto. Additionally, we'll use the display property set to flex to align the links horizontally. Similarly, the list item with the class navItem will have 0 padding on the top and bottom and 0.5rem padding on the left and right. Next, we will style the navigation link with the class navLink. we will set its position to relative, color to white, and font weight to 600. After completing the CSS styling for larger screens, the next step is to ensure that our navbar is responsive for smaller screen sizes. In order to achieve this, we will specify a CSS breakpoint targeting screen sizes that are less than 768 pixels. This will allow us to apply specific styling to the navbar when viewed on smaller devices. In our responsive media query, we will start by targeting the UL element with the class of navbar, which contains the navigation links. First, we'll set its position to fixed to keep the navigation links visible when the user scrolls. We'll also make its width 100% and align it to the left edge of the viewport by setting the left property to 0. Additionally, we'll position the navbar 105 pixels below the top of the page by setting the top to 105 pixels. To vertically and horizontally center the navigation links, we'll set the flex direction to column and use justify content center and align item center. The background color will be set to black. Since the navigation links will initially be hidden on mobile devices, we'll set the height to 0, opacity to 0, and visibility to hidden. Finally, we'll add a 0.5 second transition to it. Similarly, for a smaller device, we will customize the toggle icon label. First, we will set the font size to 2rem, display to block, cursor to pointer, and color to white. In our mobile devices, the navigation link will initially be hidden. We will show the navigation link only when the user clicks on the toggler icon. To do this, we will target the checkbox input within our navigation section when it is checked. When the checkbox is checked, we will target its sibling element with the class navbar. To make the navigation link visible, we will ensure that its height expands to 100%, the opacity is set to 1, and the visibility is set to visible. Now that we've successfully implemented the toggle functionality with HTML and CSS, we can see the navigation link being toggled when we click the toggle icon. Moving forward, we'll enhance the mobile experience by customizing the navigation link with a white color and a font size of 1.1 rem. Additionally, for the navigation item, we will apply a top and bottom margin of 15px and set the left and right margins to 0. With this, we have completed this tutorial on creating a navbar using HTML and CSS. Also, if you would like your navigation links to have an animated effect when users hover over them, you can find a tutorial on creating a beautiful hover effect for nav links on my channel. Finally, we are all set to wrap up our tutorial on creating a navbar using just HTML and CSS. If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please leave a comment. Thanks for watching.